For the Marcos administration's multi-party alliance, finally revealing its senatorial lineup for the 2025 midterm polls. Interior Chief Benher Abalos was the first candidate to be announced by President Marcos. Five incumbent senators will also gun again for a Senate seat under the Bagong Pilipinas Alliance banner. These include Senators Abong Revilla, Francis Tolentino, Lito Lapid, Pia Cayetano, and the president's sister, Aimee Marcos. Three former senators, including former Senate President Tito Soto, will also be attempting to return to the upper chamber. Completing the administration slate, Makati Mayor Abby Binay, House Lawmaker Camille Villar, and ACT-CIS Party List Representative Urban Tulfo. Marcos touts the accomplishments and experiences of the 12 whom he says will greatly contribute to the country's development.
Napagsasamahin ang 12 magigiting na Pilipino na may taglay na sipag at galing para maging pinuno. Tangan ang prinsipyong makatao, makadiyos, makabansa. Titindig para sa interes ng bayan at sa kapakanan at karapatan ng bawat isang Pilipino. Sa aking pag-endorso, ang tanging hiling ko ay mapanatili ang kanilang katapatan at pagmamahal sa bansa. Ito ang pinakamahalagang katangian ng kandidato na aking tinitignan at pinag-iisipan. Sila ay ating magiging katuwang sa ating pagsulong at sa patuloy na pag-unlad ng ating bansa. Atin po sila ay samahan at suportahan.
Marcos started forming the Alianza para sa Bagong Pilipinas last May as a continuation of his unity campaign. The alliance is composed of five major political parties in the country, including the President's Partido Federal ng Pilipinas and the Martin Romualdez-led Lakas CMD.
Ang sabi nila, ang halalan daw ay panahon ng pagkakabitak-bitak, pagsisiraan, pagkakahati-hati. Subalit, kabaliktaran po ang inululunsad ng ating alyansa. Sapagkat ito ay isang kilusang bayan na magbubuklod sa pinakamalawak na puwersa ng mga nagmamahal sa inang bayan, na ikakampanya ang isang programang pangkaunlaran.
Unity is crucial. Each of our parties, whether it be Partido Federal ng Pilipinas, Lakas CND, the National People's Coalition, and the National Lista Party, or the National Unity Party, represents different perspectives, histories, and stories. But today, we come together not as separate groups, but as one force for the people. We stand united because we know that in unity we find the power to turn our dreams into reality.
Meanwhile, Vice President Sara Duterte says she has neither formed nor plans to endorse a Senate slate in the 2025 midterm elections. This, as she asserts she is more focused on defending her office. But Duterte notes she is not closing her doors on possibly endorsing several candidates next year. Duterte, who heads Hugpong ng Pagbabago, also says her regional party has yet to begin discussions on possible alliances.
We'll see. Malayo pa naman kasi yung kampanya. Sa February pa siya magsisimula. So tingnan natin, baka pagdating noong February, ano na, medyo maluwang na.
The vice president earlier said her father and two brothers will vie for Senate seats in 2025, but she now admits she is unsure if that will push through, saying she only heard about those plans from the people surrounding her family. And a former education official reveals receiving bribes from the office of the then education chief, which she believes may have been meant to influence the bidding for supply contracts. Vivian Gulia reports.
Gloria Mercado turned over to a House panel on Wednesday nine envelopes that allegedly used to contain 50,000 pesos each. The envelope was labeled HOPE, or Head of Procuring Entity. Mercado said she was handed one of these envelopes every month since assuming her post as HOPE for DepEd in February 2023. and she was told that it came from then Education Secretary Vice President Sara Duterte.
These envelopes were handed to me mostly by Assistant Secretary Sunshine Fajardo, which she says came directly from Vice President Duterte.
A congressman asked, what is the money for?
Or should I say, it is a means to influence your decision being the hope.
It could be.
The former deputy official, who had been in public service for 40 years, said she did not immediately open the envelopes and hoped to return it during the exit call she requested before going into voluntary retirement. But the exit call did not happen. She was advised to donate it, which was the first time the envelopes were opened.
And it was 50,000 per envelope.
So 50,000 times 9.
It's 450 po.
450.
They issued me a receipt for that 450.
Mercado said she voluntarily retired after she was asked to resign by Duterte's chief of staff. So this came days after Mercado asserted in October 2023 that procurement for the DepEd computerization program must be implemented and conducted in strict adherence with the rules.
As the likelihood of a bidding failure for DepEd computerization have become apparent, I was approached, by Attorney Monsayak, and he suggested mag-usap-usap na lang para hindi masayang yung pera ng 2023. I firmly asserted that the procurement must be implemented and conducted in strict adherence with the rules. Sometimes in the third or fourth week of October, I was summoned by Zulaika Lopez, the Chief of Staff of the Vice President. I was informed that I should tender my resignation effective that day. I refused to resign and I insisted on departing from service through voluntary retirement.
Wala akong dahilan o interes o inclination na magbigay ng isang illegal na order sa isang publikong lugar na may mga tao na hindi ko man lang kilala.
Duterte did not attend Wednesday's hearing of the House Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability. But in a press conference, the Vice President challenged Mercado to present documents to prove her claims against her and her staff. Duterte said Mercado was let go after she sent an unauthorized solicitation letter to a company in 2023 to ask for 16 million pesos on behalf of the DepEd.
Gloria Mercado is a disgruntled former employee of the Department of Education. She was let go because of loss of trust and confidence sa office of the secretary. And then she said na pwede bang mag-retirement na lang ako instead na paalisin ninyo ako. Kasi ang tagal ko na, matanda na ako. And then sinabihan siya, okay.
Duterte added Mercado appointed a teaching personnel from Central Visayas to a non-teaching post in the DepEd headquarters, a move which was considered irregular and received complaints from teaching personnel.
Ginawa niyang executive assistant niya. Ang apelido nun, Villar. Meron niyang paper trail.
The Vice President added, Mercado's revelations against the DepEd in the congressional inquiry did not come as a surprise, as she is known to badmouth her colleagues without sufficient basis. Duterte earlier wrote to the House Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability, saying that she would not attend their congressional inquiry as she finds the probe unnecessary. But Committee Chairperson Joel Chua noted an alleged disturbing pattern in the disbursement of OVP's confidential funds under Duterte in 2022 and 2023, adding that the amount of potentially misused funds surpasses the threshold for plunder.
When one goes deeper and looks at the liquidation reports for these disbursements, a disturbing pattern and similarity emerges with perfectly round numbers. Ni isang sentimo po ay walang butal. Being attributed to expenses such as medicine and food, paulit-ulit po at parang kinapipaste ang liquidation ng confidential funds ng OVP.
Meanwhile, the Vice President rejected calls for her to step down. Several lawmakers earlier said Duterte should just resign if she isn't interested in fulfilling her job as Vice President after the second-in-command snubbed several congressional proceedings, including the plenary deliberation of her office's budget for 2025.
Kasi ako sasagot sa Young Guns dahil kailangan ko sumagot sa 32 million na bumoto sa akin, hindi sa isa or dalawa na tao.
Duterte alleged that calls for her resignation is a second track created by her political opponents after failing to find a ground for impeachment against her.
Sa tingin ko, sa mga nangyayari, wala silang kaso for impeachment. Kaya sila nandyan. Kaya sila sige hanap ng kung ano ang gagamitin nila. Gumawa sila ng isa pang track na resignation.
And while Duterte has snubbed House deliberations, she guaranteed that she will attend the OVP's budget deliberations in the Senate plenary. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine lawmaker Johnny Pimentel standing by the credibility of Duterte's accuser. Pimentel says former Education Undersecretary Gloria Mercado, who is respected in the academe, volunteered to testify. He adds more individuals are willing to step forward to shed light on the matter.
Bukas nga, meron na naman kaming bagong resource person, dalawa. So, actually, marami ho ang nagbo-volunteer. Pero yung iba, nasa active service pa. They do not want to come out. Pero nagkakatugma-tugma naman yung mga sinasabi nila sa amin. And these two persons, nag-under oath na.